With the development of four-stroke internal combustion engine, petrol became essential to automotive industry. Today, almost all petrol is used to fuel automobiles, with a very small percentage used to power agriculture equipments and aircraft. Welcome to GNP Animations. In this video, we are going to see how petrol is made. The petrol, also known as gasoline, is a volatile flammable liquid obtained from refinement of petroleum or crude oil found deep within the earth. The crude oil itself derived from decayed organisms that were buried along with the sediments of early geological eras over tens of millions of years. This organic residue called kerosene was converted to crude oil by a pair of complex chemical processes known as diagenesis and catagenesis. The combination of these complex reactions creates a hydrocarbon mixture known as petroleum or crude oil. There are many steps involved in manufacturing of petrol, but in this video we are simply going to see four steps. Step 1, collecting the crude oil. Step 2, separating the petrol. Step 3, purification of petrol. Step 4, octane rating. The first step in manufacture of petrol is to collect the crude oil. Finding crude oil reservoirs is a long and complex process. It can take years of research. These reservoirs can be at depths of more than 3000 meters or hidden under thick layers of salt deep below the seabed or trapped in geological faults where the rock is folded into complex structures. Seismic reflection imaging remains the most widely used geophysical technique in hydrocarbon exploration. And there are three primary types of drilling operations used to bring the crude oil to the surface: cable tooled drilling, rotary drilling, offshore drilling. After oil is collected, gross contaminants such as gases, water, and dirt are removed. Since crude oil is a combination of many different hydrocarbon materials, it must be separated into its compounds. And that brings us to the second step, separation. Fractional distillation is one type of separation process. It involves heating the crude oil to separate its components. In this process, the stream of oil is pumped into the bottom of the distillation column where it is heated. The lighter hydrocarbon components in the mixture rise to the top of the column, and the most of the high boiling point fractions are left at the bottom. The columns used to separate lighter oils are proportionally tall and thin. Tall distillation columns are more efficiently separate hydrocarbon mixtures because they allow more time for high boiling point compounds to condense before they reach to the top of the column. The condensed liquid fractions can be collected separately. The fraction that is collected between approximately 20 and 70 degrees centigrade is petrol. Fractional distillation itself does not provide petrol. It just removes the petrol from other components in crude oil. Further refining processes are now used to improve the quality of the fuel. Step 3, purification. Once the oil has been distilled into fractions, further processing in a series of chemical reactions is necessary to create petrol. Catalytic cracking is one of the most important processes in oil refining. This process uses a catalyst, high temperature, and increased pressure to affect chemical changes in petrol. Catalysts such as aluminum, platinum, processed clay, and acids are added to petrol to break down larger molecules so that it will possess the desired components of petrol. Another refining process is polymerization. This is opposite of cracking. In this process, it combines the smaller molecules of lighter gases into larger ones that can be used as liquid fuel. In olden days, compounds of organic lead were added to petrol to reduce knocking in engines. But due to environmental concerns, this is no longer common. Other chemicals are added to petrol to further stabilize it and improve its color smell in a process called sweetening. And then, antioxidants are added to prevent the formation of gum in the engine. Gum is a resin formed in petrol that can coat internal parts of the engine and increase wear. Step 4, octane rating. The petrol is primarily a mixture of two volatile liquids, heptane and isooctane. Pure heptane, a lighter fuel, burns so quickly it produces a great amount of knocking in an engine. Pure isooctane evaporates slowly and produces virtually no knocking. The ratio of heptane to isooctane is measured by the octane rating. The greater the percentage of isooctane, the less knocking, and the higher the octane rating. And finally, the refined petrol is carefully stored in tanks for shipping. And this is how petrol is made.